You're on the starship Voyager. I'm Captain Catherine Janeway of the United Federation of Planets.
I'm Dareth of the Vidian Sodality.
You attacked one of our crew members, and you've lured us into this asteroid. Why?
We are gathering replacement organs and suitable biomatter. It is the only way we have to fight the Phage.
A virus? Some kind of disease?
Yes. It attacked our people over 2 millennia ago. It consumes our bodies, destroys our genetic codes and cellular structures.
So you harvest the bodies of other beings to replace your own tissues as they're consumed by this Phage?
Our immunotechnology cannot keep up. The Phage adapts. It resists all attempts to destroy it. Our society has been ravaged. Thousands die each day. There is no other way for us to survive.
I have a great sympathy for what your race has endured. But I cannot allow you to keep the organs you removed from one of our crew members. We need them back immediately.
I'm afraid that isn't possible. I have already biochemically altered the air-breathing organs and grafted them into Motora's body. They are a part of him now. He is my Honata. His task is to find the organs I need for survival. We try to extract them from the dead. But sometimes, when the need is immediate, more aggressive actions are required.
So now I am left with the same choice you made. Whether to commit murder to save a life, or to allow my own crewman to die while you breathe air through his lungs.
It must be impossible for you to understand how any civilized people could come to this. Before the Phage began, we were known as educators and explorers. People whose greatest achievements were artistic. I myself am a sculptor of note on my world. All I can say is that when your entire existence is at stake...
You don't have to explain yourself, Motora.
If the consequence of this act is a death sentence, so be it. At least it will put an end to my suffering.
I can't begin to understand what your people have gone through. They may have found a way to ignore the moral implications of what you're doing, but I have no such luxury. I don't have the freedom to kill you to save another. My culture finds that to be a reprehensible and entirely unacceptable act. If we were closer to home, I would lock you up and turn you over to my authorities for trial. But I don't even have that ability here. And I am not prepared to carry you forever in our brig. So I see no other alternative. But to let you go. Take a message to your people. If I ever encounter your kind again, I will do whatever is necessary to protect my people from this harvesting of yours.